Welcome once again to Primetime Wrestling. I'm Gorilla Monsoon, flanked by the Brain, and over in Studio B, of course, is the Hot Rod, who's having a killing problem today. Something's bothering him.
Once you get a weasel in your house, you can't get them damn flies.
I got some special news for all our primetime viewers. I want to get this off my chest right away because it is exciting. It is special. It's something that I think everyone's going to be proud of, Brian, when we finally put this thing together.
Survivor Series Showdown.
November 12th is the date. Mark it on your calendar. It will happen right here on the USA Network on Primetime Wrestling. Survivor Series Showdown, starting time 7 p.m. 5 exclusive matches. Getting ready for Survivor Series. We're going to have some further information for you later on in the program about these matches, how these matches were made up. But right now,
it's a Sunday, you know.
I know it's a Sunday.
Well, tell the humanoids.
Hot Rod, you all right over there? You're banging away.
I'm doing great. Well, I was clearing flies. First of all, that he always gets mad when I say hello to you first, Gorilla. Hello, Mr. Root Canal. It's wonderful. The Root only Canal. Guy since he's got this argument with Root and me gone, only person that's shedding more tears is Tammy Faye, man. Of course, I've been reading this book about Betty's Diary, some of the finer reading Bobsy left here under the couch here. Betty's Diary, how Boobsy invests in the stock market. Get King Haku.
Whose money?
I invest my members of my family's money quite well.
With or without their knowledge, I assume.
I got a question for that. I have total card blanche.
I got a question. Yo-ho, Rennie, I got a question. How come if you're so doggone rich and you're from Beverly Hills, you're the only one that ain't got a tan?
Allergic to the sun, perhaps.
I wear a hat when I play golf.
You wear a hat when you play golf.
I don't have time to go to tanning booths.
We've got some tremendous matches lined up here this week on Primetime Wrestling. Our feature, of course, Brutus the Barber Beefcake, taking on the Hammer Valentine. But right now, we're going to go down to ringside, take a look at Mr. Perfect. Mr. Perfect, looking good here this week on Primetime Wrestling.
That moron, Tony Giovanni. Go back to Gorilla Monsoon and Piper. What am I? Just sitting here holding papers?
Chopped liver. I think you referred to as chopped liver. I'm not sure.
I like that one, Gurr.
You know, we're going to have for you in this particular edition of Primetime Wrestling and next week as we go along. And before we reach our date, when November 12th, when our special Survivor Series Showdown will air
Sunday
at 7 p.m., we're going to tell you exactly how these matches were derived. You know that there are 10 teams in the Survivor Series. 4 members on each team, so 40 names went into a hat. Is that correct, Hot Rod? Am I?
40 names went into a hat. And the thing about it is, the beauty of this is we're going to get a chance to feel out the opponents. You see, a lot of these guys have been training as a team, and some of them haven't been there. Everybody's individual. And what they did is Jack Tunney went to his room, his office, and he put 40 names in a hat, and we picked out one name from each team that are going to be competing on the 12th. And it should be a great, I'm going to watch it personally, because it's going to give me an idea of exactly what the other teams are thinking. So I'm excited myself.
Another big point of interest right here this week on Primetime. We're going to see from Saturday night's main event, the Hulkster taking on the Million Dollar Man. You won't want to miss that. Survivor Series, Thanksgiving night in Chicago. The ramifications involved in that are so vast and so huge. Well, you're going to see what we're talking about right now as we go to this special update with Mean Gene Okerlund and something that happened in the main event. I told you it was mayhem, and it's going to remain mayhem until Survivor Series is over.
The only thing that saved Santana is that he took a cheap shot on Slick.
Saved Santana?
Martel had him going.
Will you be smart?
Martel was just about ready to reverse that figure four leg lock.
He was.
From the vantage point I had.
You knew that.
Well, yes, from my vantage point.
Studio B, do you agree?
It's a miracle that a man
that I can sit here and put up with this,
yes,
right?
Can make so much money and know so little about what he's talking about.
Right,
I want to see
could be talking
Tito.
About you.
I know I'm talking about you, Boobs. I want to see Tito Santana go against the Big Blob Man myself. You know, I want to see. Of course, the Big Blob Man, he can go there and eat 16 Twinkies before a match, and he can take his Twinkies. I don't take that away from him. But I want to see him go against Tito Santana. When Tito Santana starts rocking and rolling, there ain't very many people that can stop that guy. And I don't think the Big Blob Man's one of them. Of course, Boobs, I suppose you don't agree with me just because you're you.
Rod, you're going to get your wish because that's one of the matches that was drawn out of the hat. Tito Santana. Against the Big Boss Man that will air November 12th.
I wish
right
I
here
bet you on that.
On Primetime Wrestling, our special. Don't forget the date. Sunday, November 12th. Right now, let's take a look at Rugged Ronnie Garvin. Indeed, he is getting ready, Rugged Ronnie Garvin,
he's
for Survivor Series.
Tito.
What do you mean he's been hanging around with Tito?
Didn't you see him do that Garvin stomp?
Yes.
Well, he picked that up from an old flamingo dancer
in
Juarez.
Stop.
Same thing. Same thing the way they dance.
It's not the same at all.
Seems to be working, though, Boobs. I like that Garvin is trying to beat Valentine at his own game. He's got his own figure four, his own specialty. And Valentine, he's kind of got the same problem that Bobby does. He's got a virus in his computer. And what's going to happen is they're going to get confused here, and Garvin's going to go for the figure four. And you watch, Valentine can become a soprano himself. Candy.
That's a team captain that's talking now, so.
That's the team captain from Rowdy's Rowdy's.
That's right.
I know who that moron is over there.
I'm sorry. Now, Boobsy, no hard feelings. Let's just clear the air right now, Boobsy.
Good, you're going to leave?
Sometimes you just kill me. Sometimes I'd like to, you.
Studio B having a good time this week here on Primetime Wrestling. We'll be right back after this. The Survivor Series, one of the premier World Wrestling Federation events, heads your way on Thanksgiving night. It's a Thanksgiving night tradition. Don't miss the Survivor Series. You know, folks, a lot of people asking me, well, I don't have the pay-per-view capabilities. Well, there's another way, especially if you're one of those Dish or D-Scrambler owners. You know who I'm talking about there? Ones of you out there
hey,
have got that.
Minute,
hey, Freddie Blassie.
How are you, Monsoon?
You look like,
I tell you.
You look like you might have one of those Dish or D-Scramblers in your backyard.
Listen, this pencil neck geek you're sitting next to, he might not even be up to come up to the Survivor
Series.
Hey, pal.
This,
sit down,
this
you
cheap
pencil neck
guy right here?
That cheapskate, that's El Cheapo. This
what?
Guy, he don't even want to exhale, figuring he's going to give somebody something for nothing.
Buddy, we're pals.
The day he was born, his father, he's such a disappointment, his father gave out cigar butts. You're my pal. Puy on you.
How much does he owe you, Freddie?
$65.
$65.
I sent you that in the mail.
You sent nothing to me in the mail, you pencil neck.
Well, I'll check with my office about
you'll
that.
You check nothing. You got no office. Your office is in your back pocket. Give me my money, you pencil
well,
neck.
I just gave a $100 bill to a cab driver.
You gave $100 what?
To the limo driver.
Why, you pencil neck geek, you never had $100 in your pocket.
All my other stuff's back in the room. I'll get it to you, though.
Yeah.
Let's go to the next match.
Yeah, sure.
We're not going anywhere right now. I'll collect it for you.
Will you?
I will.
All right, Gino, Monsoon, I tell you, you're my friend. That pencil neck, I can't understand how you can sit next to this guy to hold.
Well, it's a contractual agreement. I have to do it.
I feel sorry for you and Roddy.
Monsoon, give him the money. I'll take care of you later.
You'll never get your money. Just like, your clothes are in the locker, right?
Uh-oh.
I'll be seeing you, you
come on, Freddie.
Hey, wait a minute. Fred.
Wait, what?
Wait, I'll make sure you get it.
He's going to look funny going on a plane with a sequin jacket, Boney.
He looks funny no matter where he goes, whatever he's wearing.
No, wait a minute. What's going on here? Piper can be over there by himself. He walks out here and says, I owe him some money I don't know anything about.
About the pictures that you took down off the wall?
I know.
And you broke Pencil Neck Geek, the record.
It wasn't me that did it. I know who did it.
Sure.
Me?
He wasn't even over there.
Sure, now you
they
say that.
They told me who was there. You Pencil Neck Geek, you.
See, it all comes out in the end.
$65. For $65, you ruin your reputation, you bum, you.
No, it didn't cost him near that much, Freddie, to ruin his reputation. He doesn't have one. It stinks. Got
you're
new
right,
for
you're
it.
Right, Monsoon.
Thanks for dropping by, and I'll see that you get your money.
Remember what I said. He
might not
survive until the Survivor Series.
Well, that could happen too, you know. You make an enemy of that man right there, you're in deep trouble. And obviously, you made an enemy.
Just because he didn't get his Medicare check in the mail, he'll have to pick on me.
Matchup headed our way right now. Let's take a look at the big African Dream, Akeem. Akeem will certainly be a force to reckon with in
it's
Survivor Series as he joins a team of the Enforcers. And I understand that the fashion plate is still with us.
You come to my studio, Mr. Freddie Blassie, the classy Mr. Freddie.
He's over in Studio B.
We got over here. Excuse me, Studio I. Gurr, we got classy Freddie Blassie. You are welcome in my studio anytime. One of the greatest managers ever. You got a buck there. You got a dollar bill.
Yeah, that's all I could get out of his pocket. That's all he had.
How did you get the dollar bill?
I went into his locker and went to his clothes.
You know how to get into his locker room?
I certainly do.
You got a key to his locker room?
I have.
Well,
I have.
What's wrong, bro?
I have valuables in there.
$1. That's about 50 cents more than I thought you had.
I have $22,000 in my pocket in those pants.
How much did you have?
$22,000.
He's got holes in his pocket. That's all he's got in his pocket.
Well, I've been robbed. I've been ripped off.
Wait, I have a question. This is classic. No pun intended. I have a question. You are one of the greatest managers ever in the WWF. If you were to take all the managers, now let's eliminate all of it. Let's just talk about the manager that is in the WWF now, Bobby. We call him Boobsy. He loves that name.
Boobsy.
Boobsy. Just try and go, Boobsy.
Boobsy.
There you go. What? How would you rate Boobsy from 1 to 10? Do you need more numbers? Okay, from negative 5 to 10, how would you rate Boobs? We're talking negative 10 to 10. When you take a man, let's say he takes a man like Rick Rude, and Rick Rude, just before he's going to have the Intercontinental title, he gets him into a beef. Would you do that with one of your men?
No, sir.
No, sir. Boobs, are you listening? You're listening to a man here of knowledge. No, quit sucking your thumb. You're listening to a man of talent, Boobs.
This is my show. I didn't play last night.
You didn't.
No. Hey, he needs $65 that bad. I'll make sure you get it.
But well, I've got a unlikely, Mr. Blassie, that you'll ever see that $64 additional dollars. We'll be right back with more.
I'm going to get the authority on this. My money.
Yes, Grandma Heenan. I know he doesn't like to be called Boobsy. I won't call him that anymore. I know someday he'll grow up to be just like you, but the phone never rings. You know, no, wait one second. You know, now that we've had a chance to know that we've got Tito Santana going against, who's Tito Santana going against? Big Boss Man. Thank you very much, Gorilla. Against the Big Boss Man, we have a second match that is second to none from the forecourt. We're going to have Hercules going against Macho, now let me get this straight, Macho Man King Randy Savage, that's a queen. Oh, no, with the queen, Sherry. Now we're going to have that all on the same show. We're talking the hottest doggone show. We're talking Hot Rod here. Hottest show you've ever... Pardon, Grandma? I'm sorry. Bobby? Bobby?
Oh, I've just about had enough.
Oh, you're leaving.
He brings on an 85-year-old octogenarian that's down on his luck and is trying to put the bite on me for $65. He's got a rubber mask, a banana phone over there, and a pumpkin.
Sure, the guy's left now.
Hey, I'll knock them both out if they come over here. I want to talk about something important, where I'm going to be, the Survivor Series.
Okay.
Go ahead. You got the floor. Tell us where you're going to be. Go ahead.
Go ahead. Bob?
Time is yours.
Okay.
Do it.
Go.
We haven't got time. We're going to go to the ringside right now. Take a look at Hercules. Well, I certainly wouldn't be upset about having Hercules on my team, I'll tell you that.
He's a big, powerful man. He just can't think.
Can't think.
You've noticed that,
too. He's thinking a lot better since he left the Heenan family. I noticed that right off the bat. What do you
think? Can I tell the people now where I'm going to be?
Go ahead. Floor is yours.
Friday night on the 27th, I'll be in Auburn Hills, Michigan at the Palace. My first time there.
Look out, Michigan.
Saturday night, 28th, I'll be in Madison Square Gardens, New York.
Big Apple. Be careful.
Sunday night, I'll be in Toronto at the Maple Leaf Garden.
Why do you want to mention Toronto? Primetime doesn't air in Toronto.
No, but it airs in Buffalo, New York. And if the people aren't too cheap, they can get in their cars and only drive like 60, 70, 90 miles. I'm worth it.
That's only your biased opinion. You're worth it. Well, so far, we've named two of the big matches that will appear on our special Sunday, November 12th. Survivor Series Showdown right here on the USA Network. Hercules against the Macho King, Randy Savage, and, of course, the earlier match that we mentioned, Tito Santana against the Big Boss Man.
I know who's out of the Bobby Heenan family.
Here's a guy that's not in the Heenan family, Sean Mooney. Eyes and ears of the world will be honed in on the Rosemont Horizon in Chicago Thanksgiving night for the Biggie Survivor Series. What are you looking for now?
You know what's in this bank?
Absolutely nothing if it's yours.
Zeus. That is DiBiase's money in the bank.
It is, huh?
That's right. And that's a guy Hogan don't want anything to do with.
You know what? I understand that DiBiase paid all those guys to go in there and be part of that team, that four-man team. But when it comes down to 4-3 or 4-2 or 4-1, be a different story. Here's the Hulkster.
So the snake's out. They got the snake out. First thing that happens, Hogan turns his back. Boom! DiBiase gives him a cheap shot. You can't call it a cheap shot in wrestling. You gotta take what you get. Hogan's there. Next thing I see is the one-eyed purple people eater. He turned around. He coming after Hogan. Never know what he's gonna do because Zeus himself, he don't know what he's doing. He taking orders from somebody else. But that ain't nothing. You ought to see what Jake gonna do with that snake when he catches Virgil. We'll be right back. Get into this match now.
Just adding more fuel to the fire. One more score to be settled in Survivor Series.
Last time I saw Hogan, he was laying flat.
Yeah, why? You saw why?
DiBiase put him out.
Yeah, without any help.
Right? Zeus whipped his neck around.
Some interference from the
outside.
He's
still laid out.
Sure.
Doesn't matter if
take a guy and blindside him with a 4x4, he'd be laid out too.
Doesn't matter. He's out. That's what we're dealing with, knocking him out. The guy's hit by a Volkswagen or a Greyhound. He's out.
Who's wearing the gold, Heenan?
Hogan. Right now. And you know his days are numbered.
His days are numbered.
Sure. Can't go on forever.
You ought to know about that. Anybody that's a champion that's ever been a champion in the Heenan family, their days are numbered, aren't they? Well, you don't want to discuss that, do you?
I'll discuss anything you want.
Sure.
Care to talk about that with you, though.
89 was going to be the year of the brain. Well, it started out the year of the brain, wasn't it?
Roll
and
it.
Ended up the year of the brain tumor, perhaps. Right now, let's go to Sean Mooney, who doesn't have a tumor.
Who is this guy?
Things heating up indeed for the big 10 teams in the Survivor Series that'll all go down Thanksgiving night in Chicago at the Horizon.
Rosemont Horizon.
Well,
I'll be there.
You know, the macho king, Randy Savage, the captain of King's Court. Obviously, here's a man of great character, a man of great ability who was the WWF champion, Intercontinental champion. He's obviously seen something very strong and powerful in a certain individual that we're going to be taking a look at in just a moment, referring to the Widowmaker.
Tough cookie.
Just take a look at this guy. Obviously destined to be a dominating force here in the World Wrestling Federation, Widowmaker. Studio B, what's on your mind?
Well, I got a question. First of all, did I hear, Boobs, that you're going to be in Auburn Hills?
That's what he said, yes.
At the Palace? Yes.
Well, how's about that being the buddies we are? I'm going to be there, too.
Aren't you lucky?
And there's one more thing. I have one more fight that is very important to me that I want to. It's in Glens Falls, and it's on the 28th. And there's a lady that has more guts than any professional wrestler that I have ever met. Her name is Elizabeth Morgan. Any lady on the protection of her daughter that'll do 20 months in jail, I gotta give my salute to at an honorable primetime salute because there is a true mom. And we're proud to just talk about you. And I wanna dedicate my fight in Glen Falls to you, ma'am, because I think you're one heck of a good woman. That's all
I
gotta
say. Agree with him on that.
Uh-oh, we're in trouble.
He went to jail for 20 months and wouldn't talk. Any woman that can keep her mouth shut for 20 months deserves something.
Will you stop?
Should have laid a charge card on her. She'd have talked.
Now, if you haven't gotten out and bought your Halloween candy yet, right now may be a good time to do just that, because coming up right here on Primetime Wrestling...
Wouldn't hurt a little rubber hose either.
Not one of my favorite
can make them crack.
People.
The Survivor Series, one of the premier World Wrestling Federation events, heads your way on Thanksgiving night. It's a Thanksgiving night tradition. Don't miss the Survivor Series.
And for all you folks who can't get to Chicago or don't have that pay-per-view capability, especially you Dish and D-Scrambler owners out there, I got a special message for you right now. Here's how you can partake. Just call Primetime 24 at 1-212-599-4445 and order the WWF Survivor Series. You don't want to be left out.
And for all you deadbeats
that Dish out there, get it.
For all you deadbeats that don't have a TV, if you'd have paid your bills, you'd have had
it. Oh, will you stop? Once more, let me reiterate and remind you, Sunday, November 12th, the big one, coming up right here on Primetime Wrestling, Survivor Series Showdown. We've given you two matches, Santana against the Big Boss Man and Hercules against the Macho King. And next week, we're going to give you three more big matches. But talk about guys that are big here at the WWF. Let's talk about Jimmy Snuka, one of your team members.
You want to talk about Jimmy Snuka? Here's a fella that nobody has ever been able to figure out. Here's a guy that knows no pain. He don't like me. When I refer to him as Mr. Snuka. But one thing about him, he's roaring force. He goes straight ahead. And you want to know why? Just check it out, my team member.
Superfly, obviously right at the top of his game and ready for Survivor Series.
Well, who's going to think on that team? Not Perfect can
Captain,
think.
Captain, all right. The captain's right over there in Studio B. He's a thinker.
Don't make me laugh. I'm going to manage Ravishing Rick Rude's team, Rude's Brood, and we're going to have...
You can count them out right off the bat.
The Rougeos and Mr. Perfect. But who's going to think when he's got the Bushwhackers? Two garbage men from New Zealand. Himself.
I'm thinking about only one thing at this particular point in time. I'm thinking about next week because it's our annual Halloween special here on Primetime.
Last year I sat here and there was a guy in a gorilla suit for 2 hours. I thought it was you, then you walked. I never found out who that was in the suit.
Well, Mr. Heenan?
I don't like tricks like
that. Hot Rod, who are you going to be next week?
Well, what are you going to come as, Mr. Heenan?
Oh. Oh, me? Personally?
Yeah, Rod.
I'm going to come.
Surprise us, maybe?
Or trick. I'm not going to tell you who I'm going to come as. I gotta think of just how I want to come. I got to think of just who I want to portray. And I'm going to think of somebody, and I'm going to have Mr. Heenan help me out. And when it's all done, I hope that Boobsy really enjoys it.
I'm sure he will. Feature match coming up in mere moments. We'll be right back after this.
Drop at any moment. And he does. Face first.
I can't give those out till next week. Why? Because the contracts haven't been signed yet. The names have been drawn. We know what the pairings are, but the contracts, until they're signed, I can't tell the folks out there what the other three big matches will be on Sunday, November 12th.
Well, I know who's representing the Heenan family, but if you don't tell me, I'm not telling you who you know. Why should I tell if you won't tell?
Right now for this edition of Prime
Time
Wrestling.
It's the kind of a guy that likes to tell, but if you want to tell me, I'll be glad to tell you.
Brutus the Barber Beefcake with some scores to settle.
No big deal.
He'll have his hands full with the hammer.
Wait a minute.
I think Brutus is making a mistake. You got a guy there with four limbs. On one of the limbs, he's got a big piece of hard plastic. It's the only place Brutus ain't gone for. Now, myself, that's the first thing I'd take off. First of all, we got to go to a commercial break. Then let's come back and see what we see.
The longer the bout goes, the better a chance of victory he has.
But Brutai is no fool. What Brutai is doing, he's trying to wear Greg Valentine down. Of course, that to me is the hard way of going about it. But then again, Brutus knows the hard way. So let's just check it out because we're talking action galore, and I'd love to see Valentine get beat.
Brutus the Barber Beefcake doing his thing. He's something else, isn't he?
He's disgusting.
He's disgusting. Why is he disgusting? Because he didn't give you a free haircut, right?
I want a free haircut from him. Andre didn't get haircuts now.
I could get the fashion plate. He'd be willing to give you a free haircut. Freddie Blassie, I know that.
It's too late now. He's been in bed since 8.
Next week is our Halloween, and you haven't said what you're going to be.
I have to be something?
Well, it's only customary that you...
Well, let's put it this way. If I was going to be someone, I'd want to be someone with integrity, someone with intelligence.
No, it's complete opposite of what you actually are.
No.
Well, that's what I thought.
I got an idea, though. I'm going to come up with an outfit.
You got an idea, huh?
Yep. What are you going to be?
What am I going to be? I will tell you before the program is over exactly what I'm going to be, and you'll be thrilled, I'm sure.
Is the goof in Studio B going to play?
Oh, yeah, no question about it.
What the big secret is.
What do you mean, big secret?
Well, tell me what you're going to be next week.
Next week on a Halloween program, I'm going to be the most despicable person I know in the World Wrestling Federation.
You're going to wear a kilt.
I'm going to be the guy who is the walking advertisement for birth control. That's who I'm going to be. And I'm going to show you this man's inner ego. And you're going to be surprised. But next week, right here on Primetime, our feature is going to be Hercules against Dino Bravo. And don't forget, folks, mark this date down on your calendar right here on the USA Network, Sunday, November 12th. Our big, unbelievable event, Brain.
Starts at 7 o'clock.
Survivor Series Showdown. We've already given you two big matches. Tito Santana against the Big Boss Man. And, of course, Hercules against the Macho King. And next week, we'll have three more big matches for you. Hot Rod, don't forget, Halloween.
I got an idea, Bobby. Why don't you come as a man?
Oh, that would be different.
Just give it a try.
Any parting words you might have for us, Hot Rod?
Oh, just hey, Rude.
Haven't forgot ya.
So long, everyone.
That's nice. That's real nice.